All right. Now that we've got the concrete mixed up, we have to prepare the form. First of all, what we're going to do is take the razor knife and the handle that's on it, we're going to cut it off. Same with the other side. Now, one important thing when selecting a form, you can use whatever you want to use to form it, but make sure you run your hand along the inside and the same impression as you have on the outside, you can also feel it on the inside. If you don't, you're going to wind up with just a round ball and it's not going to look like what you want it to. Okay. Cooking spray. We're going to spray the inside of it, work it around with the paper towels. At this point, a little goes a long way. If you put too much cooking spray in there, you are going to wind up with spots of it that form. And then when the concrete goes in there, it's not going to dry right. It's going to have air pockets and everything else. Make sure you get around the top edge. Now it should be kind of shiny inside, which we got. Set that to the side. All right. Scooping it in. You can choose to, once again, use the same scoop that you mixed your concrete with, a shovel, pour it straight from the bucket. You do how you want to do it. I'm going to choose to use my hands again, just so I can make sure I work it into the crevices nice and easy. Look around, shake it a little bit. All that vibration is what gets the air that's trapped to move to the surface and get you a nice smooth finish. Plastic, because I know I'm going to make a mess. I suggest that you either line your work area with plastic too, or do it outside, just so you don't have as much cleaning to do. When we're filling this, we're going to make sure that we go about 3/4 of the way full. You don't want to get it too full, because whenever you push your cup down in to make the planter hole, you're going to displace a lot of concrete. If you have it too full, it's going to come out the top. Make sure that you get everything in there nice and neat. Shake it. Try to displace as much air as you can. Got the rubber mallet over here, which is going to help with that too. That you'll see here in just a second. We'll do about one more scoop. Take the cup. Probably should have done this before. But you want to line the outside of it too with the cooking spray. This will help it in the very end, release, and save from having to cut it out. Okay. Take it, push it firmly in there. Alright, you can see the concrete working its way to the top. Run out the little hole right here. That's fine. push it down in there. Now something else you're gonna notice is when you let go, it shoots right back to the top. Once again, that's fine. Concrete weighs heavier than the cup. So I'm gonna put some stuff in here to help it out. Once again, pushing it up, let the concrete overflow a little bit. Still gonna bounce out, not a problem. We just need something heavier to put on top of it. You can use whatever you like. I've got plenty of wood laying around. I'm gonna push this back down, let it overflow. I set that on there and see if it's gonna hold it down. It may not. And it looks like it's still not heavy enough. Okay. A lot of times what you can do is put a piece of wood and then a weight on it. And that'll help out. But if you get too heavy, you're gonna push it down in there. So you need to find that right amount. That's gonna keep it in place and not make a mess. Looks like that may have done it. Make sure you get it as centered in there as you can. Take your finger, run off any excess.